What do you want, wannabe?
I want to go home. See my mom again. Put this whole nightmare behind me.
We need Barnaby Walker. We need him alive. Feel free to dispose of Nina Morales.
Right now, we have absolutely nothing to show for all the shit we've been through. You put this up your ass, and I'll kill Angel.
Where's that Uncle Flores?
It's in there in the trunk. I swear he was there.
Yes.
Please listen to me. We can help you find him, okay?
Please.
You don't want to do this. No. Please, don't you dare do this. I'm gonna fucking kill you, you fuck! I'm gonna whip his fucking fist off and shove it up your fucking ass!
What's...
Shut up!
Tienen las pistolas y se van ahora mismito como vinieron. ¡Ándele!
Sick, but I'm too dehydrated. Thank you.
The coca.
Oh, sorry, Father. I know you guys aren't much into cop knobs.
I didn't know what's we and what's petrol.
Wannabe, I found these. What the hell are you doing?
Rolling in the dirt.
Why?
I was doused considerably more than you. Clearly you thought you'd be more flammable. My hair would just go up like a thatch roof.
Just hurry up.
Look, if we go now, we can still make that flight.
We're not going to Cancun.
Why?
Angel Flores.
We can leave Mexico tonight.
Wannabe, if we do that, he'll kill us. Maybe not tomorrow, but someday. And I'm not living my life like that, looking over my shoulder. So we end this. Tonight.
I just want to have a bath and listen to the archers.
Get in the car!
Papá, ¿dónde vas?
Hey, chica, ¿dónde vas?
¡Hija de puta!
Thank you.
How are we going to find Angel?
We're not. He's gonna find us.
Hola. Buen día. Barnaby Walker, Nina Morales, room, please.
My wife opted to keep her maiden name. Very modern.
Sí, padrón. Ellos están aquí.
So what do we do now?
We wait. Animals like Angel Flores come out at night.
Oh, I think we've got a little bit of a turtlehead situation.
What does that mean?
I'm touching cloth.
What?
Room key.
Turtlehead? Oh, God.
Whew. Not waddling anymore?
Where's the cocaine?
I flushed it.
You what?
Nina, it was covered in excrement.
So?
So, no one's going to want to put that up their nose.
Are you that stupid? Do you know what they cut that shit with?
Credit cards?
Oh my God, Barnaby, that was all the money we had.
Well, at least it's off our conscience. Speaking of which, have you worked out how we're going to whack Angel?
We're gonna make this room look occupied.
Silhouettes in the window. Coat on a broom going round on a little toy train. Booby traps above the door.
What are you talking about?
Home Alone. Home Alone. You have seen Home Alone?
No.
What? How? It's the best kids film ever.
Not when I was a kid.
Well, the best kids film of the color era. I suppose you had that one with Jimmy Stewart, where he tried to throw himself off a bridge.
Don't give me any ideas, Barnaby.
Have you seen Home Alone 2?
Why would I have seen Home Alone 2 if I haven't seen Home Alone 1?
Why would you not have seen Home Alone? You know that stuff's very bad for you.
Keeps me awake.
It's not all it does. You ever seen it boiled in a pan?
Yep, and I don't give a shit.
My father used to show us. He never let us have fizzy drinks. Though he smoked and slept with multiple women and funded terrorism in the Middle East. So, you know, a mixed track record when it comes to being a role model.
Oh, come on. Couldn't have been all bad times.
Struggling to think of any good ones.
There has to be something that you and your dad shit.
Bruges.
What?
When I was 12, he took me on a sort of lads and dads trip to Belgium.
I'm just trying to picture you in a strip club.
Who needs a strip club when you've got the Gruff Museum's tapestry of the penitent Magdalene, all 10 foot of her? I'll never forget the luminous warp and weft of her hand-dyed hair tumbling down that simple cloak. So in many ways, it was my father who introduced me to my love of Flemish textiles, even though he found them truly revolting.
Hang on to that memory. I know it was difficult, but at least he loved you enough to take you on a trip to Bruges so that you could bust a nut on some old sheep.
Well, the hiccups did slightly get in the way of that tender moment, but thanks.
Thank you.
pinch your nose and swallow 10 times. No, do it. Pinch your...
They say if you can survive the first year of marriage, you can survive anything.
Congratulations, by the way. Afraid I can't let you grow old together.
I know you said that you'd kill Angel if I smuggled back the cocaine. And obviously we don't have that anymore. But if there was something else that you wanted me to mule instead, like, I don't know, an expensive bottle of hand cream that's over 100 milliliters, I think I could probably fit now that I've broken myself in.
You're good. Get up.
Picturesque.
Sorry.
Adelante, chicos.
No se mueva.
Come, join Senora Walker. I am going to tear your life apart. Everything you love.
It's an assassin, not a bear.
Get on the goddamn ground, go!
Okay. Sorry. Not dead. Really silly idea. Sorry.
Did I get her?
Before we start, who's going to be good cop, who's going to be bad cop? I think I'm naturally more suited to the good cop role, but if you wanted to mix things up, throw her off guard, I'm not prepared to strike a woman, but I sure as hell will get right up in that grill. Blow a load of Barnaby Walker in her face. I'll be the good cop. Hello.
So, you got to talk? Are you gonna make me go to work on you? Start pulling some. Holy fuck! No!
What?
She doesn't have a tongue!
Oh. And no tonsils either. Although, admittedly, that is less unusual.
I guess she's a mercenary.
You think she was paid to kill me?
Nah, you'd be dead already. Whoever wants you alive.
Maybe it's the jihadis. I mean, technically, we still owe them money.
Whoever it is, they are rich enough and desperate enough to put a price on your head.
Maybe it's Tobias MacDonald, the Duke of Norfolk. He never forgave me for telling his sister that he smoked. I don't know why I thought it would convince her to kiss me.
The Shermans.
Yep, that makes more sense. Sorry, I think I've had a bit too much sun.
This better be good news.
Have you found Walker?
You know, the next time you want a job done right, hire a professional.
Are you interested, Miss Morales? It sounds like we're hiring.
Now, give me one good reason why I would want to work with you two scumbags.
I can give you 500,000 good reasons.
He means dollars. Absolutely.
Bring us Mr. Walker, and the finder's fee is yours. Cash on delivery.
So what do you want with him?
Information. We're looking for a painting we believe came into the possession of his late father.
What painting?
Specifically a nude in oils by a mid-century Austrian artist.
Adolf Hitler.
Absolutely not.
Finally.
Even in death, my father manages to sink to a new low.
Do you even know what they're talking about?
No. Never heard of this painting, nor do I wish to.
Think your father stole it?
Well, the man had no moral compass whatsoever, so
We must assume it is a distinct possibility.
Yeah. I bet you could find it.
Why would I want to find it? I'm not my father, scrabbling around to try and flog a painting by bloody Adolf Hitler.
Yes, but all they want is information. Look, we just asked for the money up front, say that we looked for it, couldn't find it, we did our job.
No.
Well, it must be nice just to be able to walk away from $500,000.
I'm sorry, I'm not getting involved in any of this.
Don't move. Conserve your energy. It's a long walk to the nearest town.
What was she going to do? Vivisect me?
Nah, she probably just wanted to knock you out for a long time.
Come on. We have a flight to catch.
I'm sorry. I know a lot of this is my fault. But honestly, I don't know what I'd do without you.
Here. You need to stay hydrated.
Thanks.
Say patience is a virtue, but I'm not they, and I'm saying you might as well just crack on and watch even more Bounty Hunters. The whole lot is available now. And the show that should really be called Members of the Public Watching Comedians Watching Football with Friends, but it'd be a bit of a mouthful. The new one is here Thursday at 10.